And we're off. Hey there, YouTubers. This is the Flying Brick coming at you fast. And it is another gorgeous fucking day. And I'm happy. I am so happy about this wacky wild weather that we've been getting in Ohio recently. I'm watching USCV because I don't trust you. Thank you. Cool. Although, despite the nice weather and able ride, I'm absolutely not really that in a good mood. I'm actually pretty out there. Despite having to touch in and everything else and whatnot, exercising a lot, I just haven't been in a very good mood. I'm still between contracts, and I've had two companies that I really had my hopes to getting into just completely fell through, and it really, really upset me. And it sucks. But that's the nature of the beast being in IT. It's just like you never know. You know, if you leave a contract, if you're going to get another one, and then you never know when you do get a fucking contract, if it's going to be real. Like, if it's going to ever, like, be anything. You know? And then you find out, like, a year into the fucking contract that, oh, thank you for your services, kiss our ass goodbye. You know, sorry, we don't want you anymore. You know, we used you, we got the project done, and, well, we just don't think you're a fit here, even though you're a perfect fucking fit for this whole year or year and a half you worked with us. And, I hate that. No, I'm not talking about, like, my previous contract, because I love my friends. I miss them. I miss them dearly. But I left because of just how nitpicky management was becoming. And it really sucked because it ruined what was once an amazing team. And if they were to ever get rid of that manager, you know, if they were to ever get rid of the person that I don't like and start to go back to what they were, I wouldn't even hesitate to go back to in a heartbeat. I would be there instantly, and I would do anything I could to be there for the team again. But right now, as it stands, it's... I just keep hearing worse and worse things. I don't like that. It makes me really, really fucking sad. It makes me really kind of... It makes me sad that it's getting that way. Because there could be so much more. But it's, you know, being bogged down now by bullshit bureaucracy that doesn't need to be there. It's sad. But I'm still between contracts. And it's funny, too, because there have been places where the recruiters are trying to get me into. And they're like, oh, this isn't ITIL, we promise you. And I get there, it's fucking ITIL. And you're like, seriously? And, of course, they ask you, why would you leave? And you tell them the truth. And, you know, because you want to be honest with these people. You want to get your fucking job. You don't want to say, well, we just had, you know, whatever. And I told them, it's like, well, we had disagreements. And, you know, the way things were running were just not good. I just didn't care for them as much. What are you doing? What? You dumb fuck. I don't know. But anyways, I was honest. And I think that's my biggest mistake. Is that I'm an honest person. I tell it like it is. I don't sugarcoat it. You know, I don't pour chocolate syrup all over its fucking anus to lick it. I just fucking lick that anus. Because fuck that shit. I'm sick. I hate that. I hate sugarcoating things. If someone asks me, they want an honest opinion, I'm going to give them an honest opinion. And people don't like that. And I think that's probably one of the reasons why I still don't have another contract. Because I'm being honest with people about why I left. And honestly, if they don't want to fucking take me, because I'm being honest, and I'm not bad-mouthing either. I'm not saying all this negative shit about them either. I'm being, you know, I'd say I generally love the company, I love the team, but... You know, it's just the micromanaging got to me very quickly from the new management. I couldn't take it. I couldn't do it. It was just making me stressed out. It was, you know, making me take that stress out on my significant others. And I couldn't do it. I just couldn't do it. And it's so, like, sad. Because it shouldn't be that way. It shouldn't have to come down to that. And I just want to see what kind of bikes are here today right now. It's just so fucking sad. It did break my heart having to leave, but it was just like I was starting to take it out on Kieran and starting to take it out on Andy, and I didn't want to keep doing that because it would have ended up hurting our relationship. And it's just, I didn't feel comfortable anymore. Like, I didn't feel like, I didn't want to go to work. And it's just like, oh, we're going to double down on our sick policy, so you can't take any sick days. And that's kind of when I was like, what the hell am I going to do? And then I got sick because one of the other employees I worked with was sick, brought the flu to everyone, didn't want to take a day off. And lo and behold, we're all sick now. We're all fucking sick. And when I get sick, I get real sick. Like, I get fuck you incarnate sick. Like, complete full breakdown, feel like absolute garbage sick. And that's what happened to me. And it's just like, you know, my recruiting manager, it's like, well, do you really want to go back? And I said, not really. And so her response is, well, then don't. Don't go back. It's not worth it for your health and your family. So I stopped and I didn't. And she let me end the contract and we moved on. I was kind of sad, you know. And I did kind of regret quitting. And I still kind of regret quitting a few times. But every time I say I wish I didn't quit Honda, Kieran reminds me of how bad I was getting working there. How much it was affecting me. And I don't tell that detail. I don't tell all those details to, you know, the people, the would-be who wants to hire me. I never tell them those kind of details. I try to keep it as positive as possible. You know, and just say I just don't like being micromanaged. It stresses me out. I like being able to do my own thing and be left alone to do my own thing and, you know, be trusted while having someone to, like, get on me about doing stuff. So I didn't get another contract, and I think it's because I am being honest. And the thing is that if being honest about why you left your previous company and it was for good reasons, because it was actually hurting your family, that's when I draw the line. Like, if you don't hire someone in because you're worried about them skipping town or whatnot because they have, you know, they're afraid that you might micromanage them and whatnot, if you're that much of a coward to not care about people, to listen to what caused them pain and try to be a better person, a better manager, then I don't want to fucking work for you. And it's really aggravating because, you know what? I don't know. Maybe it's just the Ohioan attitude. Just, I don't know, man. It's just like this fucking attitude of I don't give a shit. Or maybe it's this Midwestern attitude. I don't know. It's like, I don't give a shit about your problem. It's not my fucking problem. I don't know. But you know what? Move on. Live and learn. Don't be honest, folks. I don't know. I have a hard time not being honest. But you know what? Maybe that's it. Maybe we should all just be fucking like Star Wars liars. I'm not gonna fucking lie in an interview about stuff I know. I'm not gonna lie and embellish my shit. I'm not gonna lie in an interview about how, I wanted to look for better options out there. I can't. I'm terrible at lying. I'm very honest. I hate not being able to be honest with people. It's like it kills me on the inside a little bit. And another thing too is that the funniest things in life, almost all the time, the funniest things in life aren't fabrications. They're not lies. It's the fucking truth. So you can embellish the truth a little bit when it comes to humor, just to kind of make that thing stretch out. But, you know, as George Carlin would say, but I still don't feel comfortable doing even that. For instance, here's a good thing. My pop lost a bit of his hair and his eyebrows. So he gathered all this wood in the pile. I'm in the kitchen making something for us to eat. He starts pouring some gasoline on. I thought I'd just put probably a little cup on it to get started. Phone rings. Chuck comes in. All right, cool. Nothing major. Just a stupid telemarketer, I guess. I don't know. I forgot what it was. He goes back outside. And next thing, I'm turning around, all of a sudden I just see this bright motherfucking flash. And I'm like, holy shit, a big fireball. And there's Chuck smoldering like 10 feet away from me. I was like, oh my god. The fucker was lit up like a Christmas tree, literally. But no, he was fine, came in, and I said, you know the quote, Adam Savage, Pop? are you missing an eyebrow? He's like, am I? I'm like, you're missing both your eyebrows and half your hair. Oh, man. But yeah, good old reality. And none of that wouldn't have happened if he didn't pour, I think he poured the whole 5-gallon tub on that thing. This thing does not want to shift today. It's been, I might have to do an oil change on it. But, I think he poured the whole thing of gasoline on there, and then, yeah, the fumes just kind of, yeah. It was funny, though. Whoosh! Go, SUV, go! Let's see how fast this SUV is going, ready? This is a 55, by the way. About 75 and a 55, because I'm an SUV. Yeah! Holy crap, and it's going! It keeps going! Look at it! It just keeps speeding up! Yeehaw! Oh my god! What are you? Wow! I am terrified there's going to be a cop. This is why I talk about Ohio drivers, ladies and gentlemen. What fucking speed limit? And I know I'm doing the speed limit with them, but I'm curious as to, like, why they're going so fast. I normally don't go this fast on this road, unless I'm being, silly. Oh, shit. Okay, good. I thought that was a cop. I was like, oh, fuck. That is not a cop, but it's another SUV. It's gonna go fast. Nope, thought that was our car, but it's not. 80 and a 65. Yeah, baby. Buffer that wind for me. Buffer it good. Buffer it, you fucking box of shit. Oh my god. Tattletale.com? What? What the fuck is that? Tattletale.com? That doesn't sound good. Tell on you? 888 tell on you? What the fuck? What the fuck? 888 tell on you? Well, he's doing 80 and a 65. I'm gonna probably edit out of the video because I want to see what that is. Like, I want to see what the fuck that is, because that seems like some pretty serious douchebaggery right there, folks. Like, that's some serious bullshit. Like, if you're that much of an asshole, I don't know. What are they going to tell on you, what? That, you know, you smoke pot or something? I should tell on him. I should fucking call him up and tell on him. Because he's doing fucking 80 to 60. I'm just kidding. I wouldn't do that. I'm not that much of an asshole. I wouldn't do that to him. And I'm like, and also I hate lying, I guess you could say, and hate the lying bullshit. I hate being a hypocrite. And I have been a hypocrite sometimes, but I acknowledge that. I acknowledge when I'm being hypocritical. Daniel Lane. Oh, that's the wrong turn. Whack, right into me. Oh, there goes my motorcycle and my legs. Probably my shoulder, even my head too. I will say one thing. If I ever die on my motorcycle because of anything, be it my fault or the fault of another fucking moron, like that woman behind me or in front of me, I want my husband and our boyfriend to rebuild this motorcycle if they can possibly do it, and ride it all the time, both of them, to cherish me, cherish my memory. But I don't think I'm gonna die anytime soon, and I hope to God I don't lose a limb because of some fucking moron, but I will hang in there. I will hop if I'm losing a leg and beat them to death with that fucking leg. If it gets torn off because of a fucking retarded driver. One church. It's always one church. Why is it always one fucking church? It's always the one church, the only church, the first Baptist, the first evangelical, the first Pentecostal, blah, blah, blah. It's always the first. What is the significance of first? You're a goddamn fucking another church that sucks tax money away. Kiss my ass.
You're not first. You're like 14 billionth. Done a million fucking times before. Am I going to be able to make this? Nope. I don't fucking get it. Like, the whole naming scheme. If anyone knows, like, the whole first whatever, like, I understand my religions very well. I understand Christianity. But I never understood the naming scheme for, like, Protestant churches.
I just never understood that. It's like, what's the whole first about? Okay, good. Whoa, you... Three times! It's like, dude, I have a green light. Not even looking, not even fucking looking at all. Oh.
Hey guys, thank you for watching. I want to thank my subscribers so very much for tuning in. If you like what you see, subscribe to the channel. We post every Tuesday and Thursday.
Family fellowship. Sure. Walk in there with my family. Who the hell are you? It's the queers. The queers are here. Them faggots. Them faggots come knocking. Hail Satan!
You butthole! Look what he's doing right now!